was kind of like, I started posting Stardew Valley videos in the beginning of my channel. I think it was the third or fourth video that I ever posted on the channel. And, you know, I didn't have like a rhythm of how videos would go, and it was just brand new. So I don't think I was doing the series really good justice. So I think now, you know, I'm kind of used to making videos and kind of trying to blend them out a little bit. And I think we can make the Stardew Valley series something pretty great, as long as you all enjoy it, of course. So I'm kind of gonna skip the whole beginning thing, like making your character and whatever, and I'm just gonna start back up with you guys when I'm in the game. We are on our farm. I really like this haircut. It's really cute. I think it is one of the new ones. So it's the first day, so we got a present. We got turnips. You received 15. Oh, sorry, they're parsnips. Did I say turnips? Sorry, I got Animal Crossing like way too far in my brain. You received 15 parsnip seeds. Here's a little something to get you started, Mayor Lewis. So in case you've never seen Stardew Valley before, the backstory is your grandfather passed away, and he left you this farm, and you used to work in, like, this city. And now you're here in Stardew Valley, where he had this farm, and he's left it to you, to help you kind of figure out what you want to do from, that transition from busy city life. First thing I'm gonna do, you know it, is fix this to the way that I usually have it, because I need a little weapon there. It's just, I'm used to this, so that's how I'm gonna keep it. Let's go outside and see what happens. Okay. So it's just basically teaching us how to move around and stuff. We can get the menu from there. You can also do the quick menu from here. But I think this one just takes you directly, whereas this one brings you to crafting, so. Skipped even the intro when you get here. So basically Robin and Mary Lewis come, and if you don't know who they are, Robin is the carpenter in town, and she lives on the map kind of up, and Lewis is the mayor of the town. And they basically, Robin dissed your old grandfather's farm and said it looks like garbage and was super rude. Okay, Robin's a little rude, y'all. What am I doing? And, the mayor was basically like, no, it's, you'll get it, it'll be fine. So the first thing I like to do on day one is I like to basically clear up some area, because, you know, that's super important. It wants us to check journal here. So getting started, it says if you want to become a farmer, you have to start with the basics. Use your hoe to till the soil, then use a seed packet on the tilled soil to sow a crop. Water and stuff that will fall from the tree, so you can, well, you can plant them. Sometimes they fall doing that. Get rid of this one here. Whoops. Oh, you know what? I forgot to turn on something I always turn on. Too late. Is is, I'm not gonna lie, straight up how you're gonna make an income until you get a good size crop. Just straight up go to the beach and collect things and fish, and you will make pretty good money for the beginning anyway. There's good water here in the valley, all kinds of fish. Oh yeah, my shop's back open now, so come by if you need supplies. If it smells, it sells. That's what my old pappy used to say anyway. Okay. Our first cutscene. You get those a lot when you become friends with people in town. So Wally Fish is here because it's 7 a.m. so I don't even, his shop's not open, so he fishes there. And then I think after 4 p.m. he fishes here. So now we got this fishing rod, but we can't really fish because we don't have any room currently. So we do need to make a chest. But as you can see, there's tons of stuff on the beach that we really need to come and collect, and we can sell. And you'll see we'll make some good money. Also, one of the first things we gotta do is we gotta pay 300 wood to fix this. So we'll have to cut some trees down, but that opens up a part of the beach that has more valuable things for us to sell, so pretty cool. So this is the town. Oh, that's the graveyard. Sorry, that's not the town. This is the town. That's a part of the town, I guess. This is some of the residences. This is the Star Drop Saloon, and we'll get to know these characters more. This is Pierre's, which, wait, wasn't there a sign on, oh yeah, there is, I just can't see it. So this is the thing, it shows events, the, what is this, a calendar. My goodness, this is the calendar, and you can see, when there's events and things going on. And there's also, help wanted signs, but no one's posted anything. This is Pierre's, this is the hospital, and, there's a lot of places, but for now, let's get back and try and get those few things to do off our checklist, and then next time we will spend more time meeting people, meeting the townsfolk or the town villagers. Well, it's a town, so I guess town folks. I don't know, maybe like just the neighbors. I don't know what you would call them. So it's a new day, which means we gotta water our plants, if I can remember how to do such a thing. The parsnips. Now parsnips grow quick. They're pretty cheap to buy. Like the seeds are the cheapest for this season. Each season has a cheap seed. And that thing usually grows pretty quick. And you can sell bundles of them. Usually like quite a bit, but because they're cheap, they don't sell for a lot. So it's kind of up to you how you want to go about doing things and getting money. But I'm gonna just play the way I usually do to gain income based on what I've learned playing and things like that. We also want to get to the cave soon. Eventually, we'll be able to get there. I don't even think we can get there the first week in game because we're working on all this other stuff. So I'm just cutting these trees down. First, actually, I should make this chest. Oh man, there's nowhere to put it. Whoops. We'll just throw those out. It's fine. We need a chest, which I'm going to put right here. Wait a minute. Oh, yeah. I can just place it. So this chest, we're going to throw our stuff in there. Okay, so for today, oh, it looks like it's raining. We're going to have to probably just makes it way easier. A lot of people were asking before when I was doing the series to include like my tips and tricks, so I kind of can do them sprinkled into the let's play here. Whoops. Which would be really great for you guys, anyone who's starting or who really enjoys this game. Even those who bought this game because of these videos, that's awesome. That's so cool. We'll just keep doing that here. Come on, tree. There we go. We're getting tired already. I might even spend the gold just so we can make some more gold today by getting a meal at the saloon. So, you know what, let's just keep doing it. We'll just keep trucking away here. I'm gonna go lower into here so we don't, like, deforest, make it look like there's, like, no trees left. We do actually have to make a path anyway, because down here is, a path to the forest and to the, because this can become hay, the grass seed, so we'll leave that for now. We also gotta figure out where the barn's gonna be. That's gonna be pretty interesting. Like a new layout, it'll be interesting to get in. A new way of moving around the farm. There are things in my farm that definitely aren't the way I would do them now, but the general layout is what I'm gonna have to really fight not doing. Let's see, I think we have almost 200 wood now, so that's pretty good. We don't want to keep that with us because we need to start making some cash, so maybe we'll just leave that for now, go buy something to eat, and then continue. I think we can eat these, actually. Also, pro tip, if you're going to choose the community center, instead of, I think it's Jojamart, which is this corporation that's trying to make like a franchise in the area of Stardew Valley, like a store, and they're going to put small businesses out of business. Oh, it's Wednesday. No, we can't go in Piers. Let's go to the saloon then. Oh man, he's just opened actually. Checking to see if you guys can. just used to be a way I could put things down, but I can't now. I think it was Y. Oh, that stinks. You used to be able to put things away if you pressed Y, but it's not working. Shells are really good for selling, so let's go and try and sell before he closes. So at Willy's, you can sell these. You can also sell them in the box. So see, we made a couple hundred just collecting stuff, so let's do some fishing. See if we can make some more. Some more. It's also long because it's just a bamboo fishing rod. There we go. And I know a lot of people don't like the fishing in this game. You just kind of gotta get a feel for it. It's a little difficult without the, there's a better rod. Everything's way easier with that rod. The bamboo rod is something that's actually quite difficult. First, but you can get used to it and then quickly upgrade because that bamboo rod's not great to catch good fish or a lot of fish. It's just frustrating. Oh, seaweed, sick. That's good to use. There's Willy right on time. Oh, it's 5. At 5 he comes out. Oh, but he didn't go fishing. That's weird. That's not what his routine usually is. There has been an update, so maybe things are a little shop closes at 5. Whoa, we're not gonna catch this one. Oh, maybe we will. Maybe I can, I don't know. Whoa. See, you have to be so precise with the bamboo. Yeah, I'm not going to. That one was a little hard. Let's try. Actually looking at it to go and spend it, but at least we got to see what fishing was like. Whoops, I'm leaning on the camera. Okay, but this pack, we're gonna eat this. Get our health back up. Just, oh, it didn't even do anything this time. Oh wait, we didn't eat those last. and see what that fish, how much it sold for. Oh, we leveled up, so we have level 1 foraging. So we have plus 1 on our axe proficiency. Trees sometimes drop seeds. We can now craft wild seeds and a field snack, which is really useful when we're doing things in the field or anything. It's like a food. So we made $50. Oh, that's okay. We're definitely going to be able to do better. We just got to build a few things up. Okay. We're going to continue out here. And 250 wood. Let's see if we can get a bit more. Do this one. I'm really bummed, actually, that I can't do what I was doing before and put things away while it's in my hand. Like, I can't put this away. It's kind of disappointing. I wonder if it's just a bug or something. Alright, let's do this. So close to making a... enough. And now we can make that bar. Oh, we also gotta water our crops. We can't forget that. They'll be done soon. Oh, there's a stone there. That's why I couldn't get it. The tree. There we go. Nice. I think we only need 300 wood. That should be it. Let's water these first. We gotta get some water. Then we should be good to go. So we'll water this. And, whoops, I definitely didn't hit that. Just run down there. We might even be able to stop at Pierre's on the way back because it's only 9:40 a.m. We get up pretty early compared to everyone else in town. So I think we got enough wood to open this up. Is it 3 or 4? I bet it's 4. Oh no, it's 3. We got the bridge done. Perfect. Okay, so the bridge is done. So now we can also collect our inventory full. We don't need the stone here. So these, whoops, sell for quite a bit. I just figured it out. So if you want to be able to do this while you're on an item, it's called item stowing. So you just go here and turn it on or off. I keep it on, because I like to be able to put things away while I'm walking around. I did not know that before. It's called item stowing. Oh, we gotta get rid of something else. Item stowing. I didn't even realize I had to turn that on. I guess I must have done it when the update happened. That's so handy because sometimes you don't want to have like a sword in your hand when you're talking to someone. So there we go. So we got a few things here. We're gonna have to go back. The first couple days are a little rough. You're kind of just running around if you're just trying to make some money, but by the time we get to the next episode, So we made about 611 gold. And so I'll put it here so you guys can see. That's 96 gold for, what is that? 48 sap. 48 saps are 96 gold. One sea urchin was 160 gold, and four coral were 320. So that stuff, if you can spare 300 wood, get that ASAP, because we just made a bunch of money just from that. And then it's 35 we made here, so 3 pine cones per 15 gold, and 4 maple syrup seeds, or maple seeds, sorry, were 20 gold. So don't really sell that, but definitely sell this stuff from the beach. That stuff's really useful to be selling and things like that. Very lucrative. So we're already on day 5 of spring, year 1. So I think that is it for today. When I come back, I'm probably going to alternate between Switch Lite or like handheld Switch videos and playing them, like recording them the way I usually make gameplay videos. I did leave a poll, and you guys, it was a little bit closer than I thought it would be, but ultimately handheld won. So I'm just gonna alternate, I think, in the series, and kind of give you guys the best of both.